Good morning, students. This is my fourth lecture on continuity and differentiability. I will focus my lecture today on differentiability only. Then we do the problems on relation between continuity and differentiability. Here, let y equal to fx be a real valued function with domain D. Y equal to fx be a real valued function with domain D and a be any interior point. We define here differentiability or derivability of a function at a point. A function f is said to be differentiable at x equal to g, x equal to a. If and only if limit x tends to a, fx minus fa upon x minus a exists finitely and should be unique. Limit x tends to a, here we define limit x tends to a, fx minus fa upon x minus a exists finitely and should be unique. Here, we tell about limit. So, existence of limit from left or from right. Limit x tends to a from left, that is fx minus fa upon x minus a x tends to a minus. Limit x tends to a plus fx minus fa upon x minus a should be finite and unique. If we substitute here x equal to a minus h and s tends to 0, this reduces to limit s tends to 0 f a minus h minus f a upon minus h, x equal to a minus h, when x tends to a minus h, this will give minus h, and in this case we put x equal to a plus h, when x tends to a, s tends to 0, f of a plus h minus fa by h, fa by h limit s tends to 0 should be finite and unique. This left expression is called left hand derivative of fx at x equal to a, and the right expression right hand derivative of fx at x equal to a. This left hand derivative at x equal to a will be denoted by symbol lf dash a or f dash a minus 0 or f dash a minus. A right derivative, right hand derivative at x equal to a or f dash a or f dash a plus 0 or f dash a plus simply. So, a function differentiable at x equal to a means left hand derivative at a equal to right hand derivative at a, and both should be finite and unique. If we have to check differentiability of a function at a point, we use this formula or left hand derivative at a, right hand derivative at a, these two or these two. Next, before starting problem, we know here geometrical meaning of differentiability of a function at a point. Here we consider a function, continuous function, and any point P corresponding to x equal to a. X equal to a, here x equal to a corresponding point P. We take two neighboring points on the curve Q and R. Here neighboring points Q and R. X equal to A, on X axis neighboring point of point A, A plus H and A minus H. So, coordinate of point Q, this height will be F of A plus H, X coordinate A plus H, Y coordinate F of A plus H. Similarly, A minus H corresponding point R and coordinate a minus h and f of a minus h. Now we find the slope of this second PQ called PQ. Difference of y coordinate by difference of x coordinate from coordinate geometry. So f of a plus h minus f a upon a plus h minus h. Slope of PR. Slope of PR. F of a minus h. Y coordinate. Difference of y coordinate. F a minus h. And f a. Or divided by a minus h minus a. That is minus h. So here slope of PQ and slope of PR. Now we consider if Q approaches to P along this way, Q tends to P along the curve. Q tends to P along the curve. If Q is very close to P, in such case, this chord PQ coincide with this line, that is, this is called tangent at point P. We see here, as Q tends to P along the curve, chord PQ, second PQ, tends to PT and H tends to 0. Here, this distance is H, this distance is H. Q approaches to P, in such case, H continuously becomes infinitely small. So H tends to 0. Limit of slope of PQ when Q tends to P. From this result, we taking limit both the sides as Q tends to P. Q tends to P is equivalent to H tends to 0. So limit Q tends to P, slope of PQ, limit H tends to 0, F A plus H minus F A by H. This expression is called slope of tangent at x equal to A on the curve PQ from the right. Slope of tangent here this way. Similarly, R tends to P along the curve. PR tends to PT. When R is very close to P, in such case, this PR coincide with this line PT. PR tends to PT and H tends to 0. Limit of slope of PR, R tends to P. Limit H tends to 0 from here. F of A minus H minus F A upon minus H. This is called slope of tangent at x equal to A from left to the curve y equal to fx. So tangent from left and tangent from right both coincide with this line PT. Thus this expression is right hand derivative at A and this expression is left hand derivative at A. From above discussion, left hand derivative at A equal to right hand derivative at A implies and implied that unique tangent at x equal to A, that is at point or dot pair AFA, that is no corner point. If there is a corner point, in such case, tangent from left this line, tangent from right this line, and these two different lines. Unique tangent at x equal to A, that is at point AFA, so no corner point. Not differentiable at x equal to A function is not differentiable at x equal to A means either no unique tangent at x equal to A to the curve or vertical tangent at x equal to A. Vertical tangent at x equal to A. If we have curve of such type, then tangent at this point will be vertical. Next, differentiability in an interval. First, open interval AB means differentiable at all points in AB. in closed interval AB means differentiable at A, left end, differentiable at B, right end, and differentiable at all these intermediate point. So at L point, all points in open interval AB, right differentiable at x equal to a means R f dash a, right hand derivative at a, finite and unique. Left derivative at x equal to b means L f dash b should be finite and unique. We have one more result, relation between continuity and differentiability. This result will be generally used in question in which both continuity and differentiability will required. B, check continuity by start by differentiability, checking differentiability. Here we have result, if a function is differentiable, this implies necessarily continuous, no need to check continuity of function. A function is differentiable at a point, must be continuous at that point. But function is not differentiable. In such case, may or may not continuous. Not differentiable, we have two possibilities. Either left hand derivative, right hand derivative, both finite but different. And second possibility, either of the two, left hand derivative or right hand derivative, undefined or does not exist. In first case, when differentiability fails, in such case function must be continuous. Left hand derivative finite means continuous from right. Left hand derivative finite means continuous from right. Right hand derivative finite means continuous from left. About a point, function is continuous from left and continuous from right. So function must be continuous at that point when left hand derivative, right hand derivative, both finite and but different, then function will be continuous at that point. But any one of them does not exist or undefined, in such case function necessarily discontinuous, no need to check continuity of function. We take a question here, fx equal to integral part of tan square x. We have to check differentiability of function at x equal to 0. F of 0, tan square 0, this is tan 0, exact 0, so its integral part will be 0. L f dash 0, left hand derivative at 0. Using formula, limit s tends to 0, f a minus h minus f a by minus h, here a equal to 0, so f of 0 minus h minus f of 0 upon minus h. Tan square minus h minus f of 0, 0 upon minus h. Integral part of tan square h divided by minus h. Tan square h exactly 0 and denominator tends to 0. So exact 0 divided by tends to 0, actual 0 divided by non-zero, result will be 0. Similarly, we using right hand derivative formula, R f dash a, limit s tends to 0, f a plus h minus f a by h, 0 plus h minus f 0 by h, limit s tends to 0, integral part of tan square h minus 0 by h, 0, exact 0 divided by tends to 0, result will be 0. So here left hand derivative at 0 equal to right hand derivative at 0, both are finite and unique, so function is differentiable at x equal to 0. One more question, basic question, fx equal to mod x, check differentiability at x equal to 0. We draw the graph of mod x. In geometrical meaning of differentiability, if there is a corner point at any point, then function will be non-differentiable at that point. If at a point function is smooth. As for example, we take here y equal to x square curve, parabolic curve. At x equal to 0, we take this chord. We take this chord and this chord. This point tends to origin about this curve. We have tangent this. If this point tends to origin along the curve, this chord becomes tangent at this point. In both case, both tangent coincide. So at zero, function has unique tangent, so function is differentiable at x equal to 0 to the curve y equal to x square. Unique tangent means curve is smooth at that point. Here corner point, we say here directly there is a corner point corresponding to x to the power 0 to the curve, so function is not differentiable at x equal to 0. Or tangent along this line has slope m equal to 1, y equal to x, slope m equal to 1. This is right hand derivative at 0, and slope of this line m equal to minus 1, left hand derivative at 0. Here 1 not equal to minus 1, so not differentiable at x equal to 0. Here we can also solve by using formula L f dash 0 and R f dash 0 equal to minus 1 and 1. Thank you.